nam sai sivaranam chaturbhujam prasannavadanam dhyaye sarva vigno prashantaye om brahmanandam paramasukhadam kevalam jnanamurtim dvandvatitam gaganasadrisham tattvamasyadi raksham ekam nityam vimalam achalam sarvahi sakshi bhutam bhavatitam trigunarahitam sadgurum tam namami om sadashiva samarambham shankaracharya madhyamam asmadacharya paryantam vande guru paramparam shankaram shankaracharyam Keshavam Padarayanam Sutravashakrutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Gururatmeti Murti Veda Vibhagine Vyomavad Vyapta Dehaya Dakshinamurtaye Namaha Narayanam Padmabhuvam Vasishtham Shaktim Chatat Putra Parasaram Cha Vyasam Sukham Gaurapadam Mahantam Govinda Yogindra Matasya Shishyam Shri Shankaracharya Matasya Padma Padam Jahastamalakam Jashisham Tam Todakam Vartikakaramanyan Asmat Guru Santatamanatosmi
Verse 12. Shantatma vigata bhayo chita mitashaha
Shantatma vigata bhayo chita mitashaha
Nirvano galita maha mano vimohaha
Nirvano galita maha mano vimohaha
Samyaktvam shrutamavagamya pavanam tat
Samyaktvam shrutamavagamya pavanam tat
Tishthatmanyapahatireka shantirubaha
Tishthatmanyapahatireka shantirubaha
Anvaya was given last time.
Lord Krishna is concluding the teaching by presenting Arjuna as a jnani, says, Tvam, Arjuna, addressing Arjuna, Tvam, you, Ujjita Amita Ashaha. Ujjita Amita Ashaha. Asha, Ashaha, desires. Amita, limitless. Ujjita, where given up. Means you having become the one who has given up limitless desires, means having got rid of your limitless desires, Arjuna, what you have achieved now, Tvam, Ujjita Amita Ashaha, Pavanam Tat Shrutva. Tat is that famous teaching of Bhagavad Gita. Tat, that famous teaching of Bhagavad Gita. Of course, here Bhagavad Gita is in anticipation.
not direct, not the teaching given on Kurukshetra by Lord Krishna to Arjuna. This was narrated in Treta Yuga, so that Krishna and Arjuna are going to take birth, this avatara, and this teaching is going to take place. It was taught by Vasishta to Rama in anticipation, because the context came there. So it is, what is that teaching, that famous teaching of Bhagavad Gita? Pavanam, highly purifying. What is the highest pure thing? Brahman, how come? What is pure? What is impure? Something other than the thing has got mixed up. That wherein something other than the thing is not that pure. What can be pure? Only Chaitanya Rupa Atma Brahma, which alone is Advaya, non-dual, where even the Adhyastha Prapancha is not there, only can be pure. Highest pure, Pavanam, purifying. Or it can be highly purifying, because it totally destroys the sorrows of samsara. Sorrows, desirable and desirable. Impurity, desirable and desirable. So the which totally destroys the sorrows of samsara, including the cycle of janma and marana. So that pavanam, the shrutam. Shrutam means madhupadesham, my teaching just now I have imparted to you. Shushrutam, sammyak, sammyak avagamya, same line, sammyak avagamya, avagamya means having known, sammyak thoroughly, totally, having known, sammyak avagamya, galita, Mahamano Vimoha San, San to be added. Galita Mahamano Vimoha. One whose Mahamano Vimoha is Galita. Galita dropped. What? Vimoha, delusion. What delusion it is? In terms of the mind. And not ordinary Vimoha. Mahavimoha. Greatest delusion. You know why? You are Paramananda Sarupa. You are Sat, ever existent principle. You are the very knowledge principle, Chit and Paramananda. But this mana presents you as what? Subject to Janma Marana Asat Vinashi. Totally ignorant of oneself and full of sorrows. Ordinary delusion, total delusion. So then we say, Galita Maha Mano Vimoha Sat, being the one who has totally got rid of the greatest delusion which is operating at the level of the mind. Asan. Apahatihi bhutva. Apahatihi bhutva means being the one who has now got rid of the wrong notion that I am going to kill my kid and kill. That klesha, affliction, that in this battle I have to kill my own people which were torturing him. So now he has discovered, so he means the swarupa. There is no question of any my doing, that is the dharma will take care of itself, because I have to, as a kshatriya, I have to do this duty, it is not for my sake, it is for dharma samsthapana. I am the, and that means akarta with this knowledge. So apahati, apagata, bandhu adi klesha. Being totally free from that afflictions, you, I have to kill all these, etc. That being not there, bhutva, apahati, bhutva, then atmani. Atmani, in Atma. What Atma? Nirvasana Atmani. Atma, wherein, in the antakarana, no vasanas are there. Vasanas, we have seen many a times that those samskaras, that software, those impressions which present us as I am the body, this belongs to me, I want this, the jagat is true, Brahma is not there, Atma is not there. All these impressions carried by us in the life, anadi, beginningless, those vasanas are what? Dropped now. So, nirvasana, antakarna, no vasanas are there, nirvasana, atmani. As a result, Atma Sarupa is manifest in its true nature. Atmani, shantatma. Shantatma. So that is the one who, and that is totally absorbed in the Sarupa. Totally absorbed in the. So Shantatma is Galita Chitta. One who has totally freed oneself from the mind. So long as the mind is there, projection of jagat is there. No mind, no jagat. That is why in sleep we don't perceive the jagat. On waking up and dream we project the jagat. But sleep is not a solution. Why? Again the projection starts. So in sleep ignorance continues to be there. That ignorance has to be destroyed. Once ignorance destroyed, mind cannot do it, it cannot revive, the mind gets totally destroyed. So Galita Chitta means having accomplished what is called otherwise as Manonasha. Manonasha. Total annihilation of the mind. Galita Chitta Ekashanti Rupaha. Ekashanti Rupaha. Ekashanti Rupaha. Ekashanta Brahma Rupa. Ekashanta Brahma Rupa. So, once having discovered oneself as Brahma Rupa, which is nothing but Shanta. Presently, are you Shanta or Ashanta? Presently, are you Shanta or Ashanta? You honest, okay? Swami, do you know it? Why are you ashanta? Why is my problem? Be shanta. Be shanta. You don't want to become shanta. Why do you want to become? In modern days, they think ashanti is shanti. That is why you see on the road, they have lost somewhere. Something is plugged in. Something is plugged in. Plugged in the air. And then, as if they have lost their samadhi. Sometimes like mad people smiling. No one there. Once it happened, I was going somewhere by the car. The one who was driving, not a driver, the host, suddenly started speaking. I said, what is that? I thought he was speaking to me. So, he had cell phone was there. It was not he had not defended the cell phone. Some device was there in the ear connected and he was talking on the phone. Then I understood. So like that. All more on the roads. right in the middle of the road, the drivers have to take care of that idiot, and they are talking. Shanti or Ashanti? So we think that Shanti. See, these devices, WhatsApp, Facebook, etc., total dependence. At least dependence on chai coffee, understood. Chai coffee, understood. Because something is. That's all that. Dependence. See, dudh wala nahi aaya. Chai nahi hai. See, when I gave the gift, such an independence it was. I gave up the key, you know, how much in 1981. Just see, till then I was having joined the ashram, one bad habit I developed was drink more tea. Generally my tea was one cup morning, one cup evening, not more than that. So when I joined the ashram in the beginning, 6 months, there was no breakfast. Oh, hungry. Big tea was plentiful like Ganga. Whatever. Big tumbler and with a good milk, etc., you can drink. So that was something was there. So that happened. Sports was over. Afterward, breakfast started at all. So I was in Bombay. So then the brahmachari. So wherever I was living, the servant used to bring this from a hostel, 8 o'clock, then I used to have it. One day it happened, I had to go for some Balvihar something program at a Mulund, for which I have to leave at 7 o'clock, so that I can reach there at any time. I mean, chai kidhar milega, 8 baje chai kidhar milega. I had money. But I felt odd to go to a hotel, the hotel, and take the tea. I could have done it. So I felt odd. So I went. You know what happened? Headache started. I never had discovered this dependence. Headache started. So okay, that day was over. After 4-5 months, there was a sadhana camp. But a 2-day sadhana camp, first one. At Talasri, on Western Express Highway, Talasri is there, Vishwa Hindu Parishad, big active center is there. There it was. So the bus was to start from Andheri, this. Of course, for me a car was there, but I had to, they were not to pick me up, because I was not that well known at that time, new brahmachari. Yes, sir. So, I had to go there. That they also be at 8 o'clock I have to reach them. The good name is there. Then I thought well in advance. That day okay. After the program was there, I could sleep and get rid of this. Now, 2 days I have to conduct the show. That camp. And if I get headache like this, what will happen? I said I should stop this habit. So first I stopped the afternoon tea. Do the then I stopped this morning tea also, the breakfast and tea. Then watch what happened. Those days I used to go to Rishikesh often, at least once or twice a year. And we used to travel in the Rajdhani Express. I was not accustomed to this AC, etc. Rajdhani Express is AC. So morning you feel cold. So morning tea comes, the warmth. Warm something, I used to drink. Then I found the day I drink, I don't get sleep. I don't get sleep. So I said, that also I stopped. So good reader. Sathya Sai Baba says, stop tea and coffee and see how you enjoy the this health. How you enjoy the wealth. I think even these tea coffees have something to do with diabetes also, I think. Sugar repeated, sugar repeated, whatever it may be. So that is fine. Okay. So Shanti. Mind is there? Shanti or Ashanti?
Shanti.
Mind is there, waking and dream is there. Now tell me, waking and dream, shanti or ashanti? Shubham. In sleep, shanti or ashanti?
Shanti.
But problem is continuing there. Ignorance, otherwise, only solution for moksha is what?
Sleeping.
Kumbhakarana will be the greatest. Kumbhakarana will be the greatest jnani because he sleeps. So that is Shantatma. So the one who is Galita Chittaha, the Manonasha has been accomplished. Shantatma. Eka Shanta Rupaha. Eka Shanta Rupaha. Eka Shanta Rupaha means Eka Shanta Brahma Rupaha. So Ataha Eva Vigata Bhayaha. Free from, therefore, for that very reason, one who is free from fear, because one has discovered the non-dual Advaisarupa Atma Brahma, fear always on account of something other than me. What is the greatest fear?
Death.
Vrittirupa Samsara. Death is the most painful event for the dying person and the surviving person. So that's why I said, samsara in vritti rupa, in the form of janma, marana, janma, marana, janma, marana. So, So, eka shanti rupaha vigata bhayaha tishtha. Arjuna, remain like this, abide in this state, live like this. With this, the 57th sarga is over. Now 58th sarga. So, 58th sarga. So, in this 58th sarga, see, by tattva jnana, by atma jnana, what happens? The avidya gets destroyed, ignorance of oneself gets destroyed along with the vasana. So that is told, and Arjuna did accomplish this and became Kritartha, the one who has fulfilled the purpose of life. Fulfilled the purpose of which purpose of life? Final purpose of life. Otherwise, to some extent, people say, I am happy. They would think it's fine, etc. Not that. Final purpose. Out of four purusharthas, dharma, artha, kama, moksha. Unless moksha is gained, purusharta doesn't stop at all. You have not accomplished the entire purusharta. So now let us see 58th sarga. Arjuna Kritarthata. That is the state of highest accomplishment by Arjuna. Thank you.
Arjuna Uvacha.
Nashto Moha Smriti Labdha.
Vat Prasadan Maya Chuta. Stitosmi Gata Sandehaha.
Stitosmi Gata Sandehaha.
Karishe Vachanam Tava.
Karishe Vachanam Tava.
Anvaya Achyuta Maya Tvat Prasadat Mohaha Nashtaha Smritihi Labdha Ed Taya Gata Sandehaha Sthitaha Asmi Tava Vachanam Karishe.
Achyuta,
Lord Krishna is addressed as Achyuta. Achyuta. Achyuta also is the name of Vishnu. You know why it's called Achyuta? Na Chutaha. Na Chutaha means, Chuta means fallen. Here fallen means will never become samsari jiva. Is always in the Sarupa, Paramatma, Sarupa, who has never become a samsari jiva. Becoming samsari jiva is a fall. You are Paramatma Sarupa, becoming a jiva, Sukha-dukha, becoming a jiva is a fall. So then Achyuta never deviated from the Sarupa, Achyuta. Tvat prasada. By your prasada. What is prasada? Achya? Krishna gave prasada to, he has not left for us alone. Kya prasada? Laddu tha, kya peda tha? Prasada. Adukra. Your blessing. Your adukra. Your, what is that adukra? Compassionate teaching. The teaching of Bhagavad Gita taught so compassionately. That is what prasada. By your compassionate teaching, of this Bhagavad Gita says, mama, my moha, moha, ajnana along with the vasanas. Ajnana along with the vasanas. Nashtaha, nashtaha. So it is destroyed. And maya, by me, what did I get now as a result of total destruction of ajnana along with the vasanas? This is what I have got. Maya smriti hi labdha. Smriti, literally smriti means memory. So here not smriti hi, your smriti. So what is memory? You recollect something experienced, is it not? Something had taken place and you had forgotten, now you recollect. It was there, but in between it appears as though clouded or lost, and then you say, oh, I got it. So here, smriti means sakshatkar, direct experience of Atma Sarupa, Brahma Sarupa, which was me. But in between, because of ajnana and vasana, as if I lost it, now I have what? Again, this goes. That's it. So smriti stands for this. What is that? Atma jnana, Brahma jnana, Atma sakshatkara prapada. See, smarana also at times means jnana. Yasya smarana matrena janma samsara bandhana vimuchyate namastasmai vishnave prava vishnave. Yasya smarana. Generally taken that? By whose remembrance? Come on, tell me whom you remember. What you remember. Is it not true that you remember what you have experienced earlier? Have you experienced Vishnu earlier? Kidhar dekha tha chowpati par walking? Vishnu ko kidhar dekha? Kidhar darshan kiya tha? And you say smarana matrena, remember, it is not told, yasya nama smarana matrena, understandable. By remembering whose name, name can be there in the name. Yasya, yasya Vishnu ho smarana matrena, that smarana means jnana matrena. You gain the jnana of Vishnu. Sarva samsara bandhana vimuchyate. Yes, he is what name is great. He is for, is it true for? Who is that person? Ravi Varma. Because Ravi Varma, all these deities' photos are imagination of Ravi Varma. Raja Ravi Varma. Raja Ravi Varma. So he was from the royal family, but not a hair.
but he was allowed to use the word Raja, Raja. See, Goddess Saraswati photograph. And these Indian ladies, that blouse they are wearing, not nowadays. Blouse they are wearing is imitation of Raja or Ravi Varma's blouse worn by Saraswati. He imagined that. So Raja Ravi Varma. So all deities are nowadays what? Imagination of, they don't give the true picture. If Lord Rama were to stand in front of us, we'll have to look like this. Once Satya Sai Baba brought the wedding ring of Rama and he circulated. Somebody said, Swami, our hand can move. That is what is Ajat Babu. So you all, how much he said? About 22 feet tall. 22 feet tall. Now what Ravi Varma presents? So it is just, you will get disillusioned if you see Rama now. So there may be somebody there. That is not the Nama is true. Nama. Rupa reclining on Adishit Sun. That is what, because some information is from the Purana. Vishnu, Lakshmi sitting at the feet and massaging, I don't know whether she really does or not. So massaging the legs, etc. And he is in what? Yogendra, if you and me sleep, sir. if Vishnu sleeps, Yogendra. So what do you mean by Yogendra? So, one is absorbed in the Sarupa only. And that is how he is the master. He doesn't do anything. And what is the department? Maintenance, sustenance department of the Jagat. And so just sitting there, he what? In his presence, everything is there. You try. Daughter's marriage. How much up and down, son's marriage, some relaxation, daughter's marriage, how up and down, run here and there, some middleman must be there afterward, somebody is there. So the middleman is very active in somebody else's marriages, but if it comes to his own son or daughter, he also goes. So like that. So one is Achyutaha, that is, Smarana Smriti can mean Jnana also. Smriti is your Sakshatkara. Smriti Labdha. Bhagavan, I have got it, Arjuna says. Taya, by that Sakshatkara, by that Smriti, by that knowledge, Gata Sandeha Sthitaha Asmi. So I am Gata Sandeha. I am free from all the doubts. Gata Sandeha. So what is that is means? I am free from all doubts. It means the root cause of my doubt is gone. Sandeha Bija. What are the root cause of his doubt? Will I not incur the sin, etc.? Now what has happened? That I notion, identifying the body has gone, there is no question of my doing anything yourself. So Gata Sandeha means Sandeha, doubt about what? Bandhu Vadhadi Karkrita. I will be the author of killing of kinsmen. That doubt has gone. And that I cannot be the Karta of this. So Gata Sandeha. Sthitaha, I remain, Sthitaha Asmi, Sthitaha Asmi. Therefore, what do now? I promise you, Tava Vachanam Karishe. I will abide by your instruction, your guidance. So, what did Lord Krishna say? Arjuna, this battle you have to fight, but not for yourself. It has come prarabdha vashat because you are the kshatriya and the responsibility of dharma raja is to establish the dharma. You become to nimitta only. So that is, it is yatha prapta. Yatha prapta means which has come unasked. You didn't want to take to this battle. You know that before that all means to avert the Mahabharata war was taken to. Part of who had gone there for the negotiation? Dharma Raja sent Lord Krishna. He said, look, give half kingdom. At least give one village with 5 houses. Duryodhana was so arrogant. I will not give the tip of the land that is on that wall, tip of the sword. See, when there is a dispute, one should not resort to the highest punishment. Highest punishment is killing, etc. So first is Sama. Sama means make the other party to understand. So this is the thing, what is the right love of the other Sama. Then Dana. You give up your legitimate right. This, it is, actually it is yours, but you give it up to just to finish the dispute. Then Bheda. Bheda means take away some of the persons of that opposition party. Separate them. If that doesn't then work, that the final punishment. Pandavas had tried all this. They tried to make Duryodhana understand that legitimate share you have to give. Work on it. Dana. Well, give us one thing. One village with 5 houses, that also he was not ready. Bheda, Krishna tried to separate Karna from the Duryodhana Kaurava, because even there Duryodhana is lost. It didn't work. Finally what? Danda punishment. That is. So that is that. This is, has come not decided by you. You are ready to sacrifice. But he didn't. But actually, Krishna, if wanted, could have averted Mahabharata war. There were only 2 persons who could have averted Mahabharata war. One is Dhritarashtra and second is Krishna. Dhritarashtra was blind by buddhi also, so that he was a god kid. Second was Krishna. He said, Krishna said, I will never stop it. I will punish Duryodhana and show the posterity that such a dharma can never be tolerated. In fact, it said, when Krishna went for negotiation, his sankalpa was that these negotiations should fail. See, when a diplomat goes, with what intention? That his negotiation must be successful. He said, this should fail, otherwise we have the opportunity to punish Kauravas or Duryodhana. So, Kanishe Vachanam Tava. I will abide by your instruction. So now, Lord Krishna.
Shri Bhagavan Uvacha.
Shri Bhagavan Uvacha.
Vrittayo Yadi Bodhena.
Vrittayo Yadi Bodhena.
Saushanta Rudaye Sputam. Tachittam shantamevantaha.
Tachittam shantamevantaha.
Vitti sattvam upagatam.
Vitti sattvam upagatam.
Anvaya. Bodhena. Hrudaye. Vruttayaha. Yadi saushantaha tat chittam shantam eva. Add tat and tat sputam.
Take this way. Tat antaha sputam.
Tat antaha sputam.
Sattvam.
Sattvam upagatam vidhi. Sattvam.
Iti vidhi. Add iti. Upagatam. Add iti vidhi.
Sattvam upagatam. Add iti vidhi.
Now you may ask like this. Arjuna has, that is told that he has got the knowledge. Why Krishna should continue? Why should continue? See, even though Arjuna has told that he has got the knowledge, isn't it? Krishna wants to, that is what? Verify and confirm it by eliminating elimination of vasanas by jnana based on reasoning. See? So long as mind and vasanas are there, it is bound to project the jagat. So that is it. So it has to be eliminated. Same thing is again repeated or confirmed based on reasoning. Bodhena, bodhena, tattva bodhena. By atma jnana, tattva jnana, brahma sakshatkara, hridaye. In the hridaya means antakarana, in the psyche. Vrittayaha yadi samshanta. Vrittaya means raga dveshadi vrittaya. Thoughts according to raga, dvesha, likes, dislikes, all these vrittaya, antarkarna vrittaya. Yadi, in case, samshantaha, samshantaha, sarvatmana shantaha, extinct by all means, no such vrittis at all. Then this is tat. Tat here, not that, tarhi, tarhi, in that case, tarhi, chittam, what chittam, that savasana chittam, mana, antakarna, along with the past, vasana, chittam, shantam eva. The chitta, you become shanta, means it has become extinct. It has become extinct. Tat. Tat, better chitta, chittam. Antaha, within, in itself, sputam, very clearly, sattvam upagatam iti vidhi. Sattvam nirvasanam upagatam praptam iti vidhi. No for certain, that chitta has got already accomplished a state totally free from vasana. When the mind is free from vasanas in the wake of atma jnana, brahma jnana, the film that was projecting the jagat is no more there. What is there is only arc light of what? Chaitanya Rupa Atma Brahma. Continue.
Atra tachetya rahitam.
Atra tachetya rahitam.
Pratyekvetana namakam. Yatvaśeṣa-vinirmuktam.
Yatvaśeṣa-vinirmuktam.
Yat-sarvam sarvatascha yat.
Yat-sarvam sarvatascha yat.
Anvaya. Atra pratyekvetana-nāmakam yat
see in the world. What is it there, Bhagavad?
Pratyekvetana namakam.
Actually, according to Tika, that the reading must be Pratyekchetanatmakam, not namakam. Pratyekchetanatmakam. Tikakara has used this word, Pratyekchetanatmakam. In some Marathi book also, it is there. Some misprint, maybe that possibly. Pratyekchetanatmakam. Present it is Chetana Namakam. After Cheta and Natma Kam. No Nama falls this much, you add Natma. Cheta Namakam.
Advaya. Atra Pratyak Chetana Atmakam. Yat and Vyavahari and Vyavahari Sarvam Yat Sarvataha Cha Yat Yat Tu
Yat and Tattvataha
Yat and Tattvataha
Tu Ashesha Vidhiru
Yat and Tattvataha Tu Ashesha Vinirbhuktam Tat Chetya Rahitam Bhavati. Bhavati to be added. Tat Chetya Rahitam Bhavati.
This is what Brahma is demonstrated in terms of your direct cognition. What is it? Atra. Atra means asyam sattvavasthayam, in the state of the mind totally free from vasana. Pratyak chetanatmakam yat, that principle. That what principle? What is that pratyak principle? Pratyak chetanatmakam. Atmakam means Swarupa. Of Swarupa of Pratyakchetana. Pratyakchetana. Have you heard the word Pratyakatma? No. You have not heard the word Pratyakatma. Pratyakatma. Chetanam chitta riktam hi Pratyakchetana ucchati. Nirmanaska sobhavam tu na tatra kalanamana. We use the word pratyagatma, pratyakchetana to I, atma. We don't know. You know what is pratyakchetana? At least word, know the word pratyak. Pratyak means innermost. Parak means external. Pratyak is innermost. What is innermost? In our individuality, what is it? Let us start first. In our individuality, what is the parag external? Body. Suppose this bullet sits here. What happened? You said? Suppose bullet passes through. Ah! I got saved. But it's here. You don't take the body as I. Anything outside the periphery of the body, you said what? External. It's a state of ignorance. Abhi tum Vedant padh rahe ho. Wo baat alag hai. Anything outside the boundary of the body is what? External. Internal. Okay. Now body. Start with the body. Now body, then come to pranas. Body is external, pranas are external. Pranas are interior. Pranas and mind. Mind is interior or prana interior?
Mind.
Mind and buddhi. Buddhi is interior. Buddhi and ignorance. Ignorance is interior. Ignorance and chaitanya. Chinnara Master is who?
Chetanam
Chitta Riktam. Riktam means devoid of. Chaitanya, free from Chittam Antakarana, Pratyak Chetanam Ucchati. It's called as Pratyak. And do you know what is nature? Nirmanaska Svabhavam Tu. There is no mind at all. Na tatra kalanamala. There is no drishya prapancha. There is no comprehension of the objective world. And that is what? Our Swarupa. And presently, that Swarupa is there or not? Is there, but intermixed with Jagat. Which is better? I think this is better, more the merrier, no? So, B is there, Jagat also is there. And it's vast Jagat. Vast or vast? I was talking to someone. Something vast, I said. That person indirectly connected me to vast. Returning from America. I was wondering, I'm not a great English expert, but my English was not that bad. That much I was confident. Afterwards, I refer the dictionary. Racket, U.S. fast. And that person didn't know that is only U.S., not the original English. Or is it so fast? Because listening to that vast, he thought that that is correct, not vast. It is the vast Jagat. No, they are the source of sorrow. We can verify, in sleep no sorrow. Why? None of these which breed sorrow are there. But unfortunately seed is, how nice it would have been. In sleep Jagat is not there. So the moksha is there, how nice would have been. So pratyak chetanatmaka, that pratyak chetanatmaka is there. The enormous eye free from mind and its products. Its projections, not products, its projection. Pratyak chetanatmakam. Yat vyavahare. That atma in vyavahara. While dealing with the world, see, what I have tried my best to find the English equivalent for vyavahar. I would not only have to compromise with dealings or transactions. I am not happy with them, but there is no better other ways. Dealings or vyavahar. In our, this is vyavahar means anything that you do, etc. Interaction with the jagat, that is vyavahar. So, vyavahari is what? Sarvam, entire jagat, is nothing but entire jagat. Not only that, yat, sarvataha. Sarvataha means sarvatra sita, with that jagat. Atma Brahma is everywhere present. It is everywhere present. But yat, vastutaha tu, tatvataha tu. That Atma Brahma, Pratyak Chetanatmaka Atma Brahma, Tattvataha, in reality, it is, do you know what it is? It is Ashesha Yattu Ashesha Virmuktam. Totally free from Vishesha. No, Ashesha. Totally free from all this, what is that? All that is mistaken to be featured in terms of jagat. Ashesha nirmuktam. Ashesha nirmuktam. And what is that nirmuktam? Tat. Tat stands for Brahma. Tat stands for Brahma. Tat. Chetya rahitam bhavati. That Brahma is rahita, free from Chetya. Chetya means Vishaya, sense of it. Nirvishayam. So Chetya Rita means Nirvishayam Bhavati. So therefore, this pratyaksha chetana, atma is what? Though in vyavahara, it appears as though endowed with jagat, left to itself in its true nature, it is totally free from Vishaya Drishyas, means totally free from jagat. Which one you would like to have? With you with jagat or you without jagat? Without jagat. WhatsApp dekhne ko nahi milega. Bhel puri khane ko nahi milega. Cricket match dekhne ko nahi milega. Chahiye? Jagat nahi chahiye? Achha. After exposure to without. Along with that, order the sorrow. All sorrows are because of in our sarupa, that is what Paramananda sarupa. We'll continue.
Om Swasti Prajapya Paripalayantam Nyayena Mayena Mahi Mahisha O Brahmanebhya Shubhamastu Nityam Loka Samastha Sukhino Bhavantu Kale Varshatu Parjanyah Prithivi Sasya Shalini Deshoyam Shokarahitah Brahmana Santu Nirbhaya Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinaha Sarve Santu Niramaya Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu Ma Kaschid Dukha Bhavave Asato Ma Sadgamaya Tamaso Ma Jyotirgamaya Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate Purnamada